So roughly 2 weeks ago, I made a video on some of the reasons why I like Android more than iOS. Naturally, I got a few people asking me if I can make a video on why I like iOS over Android. I thought that was an excellent idea. Now, maybe you guys are asking yourself, whoa, Mark, why didn't you release a video in 2 weeks? What happened? Where'd you go? Did you die? No, my friends, that's just how long it took me to come up reasons of why I like iOS more than Android. Don't get me wrong. I use iPhone as a daily driver alongside my S21, right? S21, there's no SIM card in it because, listen, I'm not rich enough. I can't afford two SIM cards. One is already bending me over enough. So this is the phone that I keep in my pocket just right around here, around home. And then when I go out, I bring my iPhone. So look, if you're using Android right now and you're maybe thinking about looking at Apple a little bit, maybe you're thinking about buying some maybe iPhone SE, you know, they're very cheap nowadays, and you kind of just want to try it out a little bit, this video is for you. So first up is software updates. The reason why iPhone works so well is because majority of the people that have iPhones are on the latest software update, which can't really be said about Android. I mean, here, just take a look at all the iPhones that are supported from iOS 14. As of February this year, 80% of all the iPhones in the world are on the latest firmware update. That's wild. But if we look at Android 11, as of this month, March, Android 11 holds over 25% of the mobile and tablet Android version market share. I mean, Android 10 came out almost 2 years ago, and only 33% of all the Androids in the world are on Android 10, a 2-year-old OS. I didn't make these numbers up. So if you want optimization and you want 80% of your user base to be kind of on the same page, well, iPhone is kind of the way to go. So next on the list, and I'm sure you guys already saw this coming, iMessage. Now wait, before you guys say, well, Mark, just use Facebook, just use Telegram, just use WhatsApp, just use Signal, just use 10 other different services. So do you see the problem with what I just said? For example, with WhatsApp's new security policy, a lot of people left WhatsApp while others stayed and they don't really care. So now person A has to download another service to talk to person B, but wait, their friend person C doesn't like either one of those. So now person A and person B has to download another a messenger that person C uses just so all three friends can talk. And by the time you're finished, you have like 2, 3, 4 messaging services on your phone when really you only could really just have one, iMessage. It's on every iPhone, it's on every iPad, it's on every Mac, it's on every Apple device. Even your Apple Watch has iMessage. It's on every iPhone in the world, one and done. The next thing is just how polished iPhones are. Even though iPhones only have 60 hertz refresh rates, the animations make the experience good enough for most. A lot of people just don't really care about high refresh rates. Us tech geeks do, but majority of the people, they just don't really care. Apple recently was number one in the global market share for iPhones, or the most amount of phones sold. I think it was quarter four of last year. That's during a pandemic. So during a pandemic, people still bought $1,000 iPhones, and Apple took over the global market share just for that one quarter. I mean, That kind of goes to say a lot of people just don't care about the bells and whistles that Android has to offer. When you're using the iPhone, you truly get to experience how fluid the animations are, right? The phone itself isn't smooth at 60 hertz, but it's fluid. For example, the S21 is a very smooth phone, 120 hertz. It looks beautiful, but it's not fluid. Sometimes the animations give a little hiccup. Sometimes one of the frames drop and you see a slight little stutter. That's kind of what I mean. You don't really get that on iPhone. Does it happen on iPhone? Of course, it happens on every electronic device. My PlayStation 5 kind of stutters sometimes. When I had the Xbox Series X, that stuttered a little bit. It happens, but it happens less frequently on iPhone. Polished iPhones come with polished firmware updates. And when you have 80% of people on the same firmware, you kind of already know that 80% of people are having a great time. The third thing iPhone does better, and I really can't believe I'm about to say this, but picture in picture. iPhones allow more customization with the video you're watching. You can drag it anywhere you like, you can hide it, you can bring it back onto the screen, you can even pinch to zoom to control how much of it you see. With Android, if you swipe it away by accident, you have to go back to the application and then flick back home to get it up and running again in picture in picture. Now, you can resize it on Android, but not to that full extent, and it's not that smooth, right? Did you see the difference of the iPhone zooming in and out on that video versus the Android zooming in and out on that video? This is what I mean when one of my previous topics was iPhone is just, it has that fluid experience. Even though it's at 60 hertz, it still has that gentle water wave ripple thing. I'm just gonna shut up. Number four on the list is third-party applications. iPhone is still kind of beating out Android when it comes to third-party applications, especially if those third-party applications have access to your camera. I actually recently did a video comparison with Snapchat and Instagram if you guys want to see. But in short, it still falls into that firmware update category. Developers have more incentive to really focus on a particular OS when they know that that firmware adoption rate is extremely high. So, for example, why would app developers spend their time and energy to update their app to work flawlessly with Android 11, right? Put in some new bells and whistles when there's only roughly 25% of people that are on Android 11. Plus, it's just much easier to optimize for iOS because iOS is just iPhone, right? Well, and iPad technically, but because that's iPad OS. So I was right the first time. Don't correct me. So there's only iPhone, right? And iPhone's Apple, and their OS is Apple. That's it, very easy. Meanwhile, on Android, oh man, you got so many different Android brands, then you got skins on top of those brands, then you got different launchers and different everything. I mean, the app developer is looking at that and damn man, I'm just gonna optimize for iPhone. Let's, you know, that's just the truth, man. That's just how it is. Number five on the list is the ease of use. Apple is just extremely good at making products that are easy to use. Apple does a great job of keeping things simple for people of all ages. Anyone, anywhere can pick up an iPhone and automatically know how to use it. There's no secrets. There's no tricks. There's no hidden menus. It's all kind of pretty obvious. Now, this isn't a matter of who's smart and who's dumb, right? When I picked up my first Android phone, I automatically knew where everything was, right? But I'm more of a kind of a tech person, more than the average person, right? But for the average person, when they pick up an Android phone for the first time, they might not really know what the hell's going on. If you pick up an iPhone 12, you know it. If you pick up an iPhone 8, you know it. If you pick up an iPhone 4, you know it. There's nothing to get used to. It's just a matter of convenience. If you pick up a product that you're already familiar with, you know it's fast, you know it's reliable, you know it'll last you a lot of updates, you're gonna pick that product again. So next up on the list is the Apple ecosystem. Now, in my opinion, and the opinion of many others, the Apple ecosystem is just quite honestly the best. And this is why. This is why it's the best, right? Because there's only one iPhone. There's one iPad, there's one Apple computer. There's different models, but they're still the same kind of one in each category of those specific things. Computers, tablets, phones, smartwatches, right? There's only one, right? That's what makes it so good. That's why they can be optimized perfectly to work well with each other. But on Android, oh boy, that's anyone's turf, man. So it's a lot harder to optimize a perfect ecosystem on Android just because there's so much options. But the ecosystem on Android is still around. It's there. So people call iOS users sheep for using, you know, the iPhone, Apple Watch, all the Apple products. They're calling them sheep, but Android is doing the same thing. Take a look at Google. They have their Chromebooks, they have their wearables like the Google Buds, as well as their tablets, which were a huge failure. Even Microsoft tried to do the same thing with their Windows Phone along with their computers and tablets, and they also failed. Even Samsung has an ecosystem, smartwatches, Galaxy Buds, tablets, and laptops. Any company wants you to stay there. Any company wants to lock you in. That's kind of the whole point. They want to lock you in so you spend more money on their side. But think about it. What's wrong with being locked in? If you like the products, why not? Will you voluntarily go into jail and stay there? Probably not. Why? Because you probably don't like it there. So you're not going to get locked into an ecosystem unless you like it. And if you do like it, then what's the problem? Apple, for now, is the best when it comes to ecosystem, but Samsung, on the Android side of things, is definitely the best, hands down. Another reason why Apple has the best ecosystem is just because they've been doing it literally since day one. Back when PC manufacturers used Windows to run on their unoptimized hardware, what was Apple doing? They made their own computers with their own software. When the iPod came out, it was the most successful music thing around. Anyone who saw it had their minds blown away. It was the best thing ever. Guess what? It worked better with Mac. When the iPad came out, it was the best tablet. Even today, it's still the best tablet. Guess what? It works the best with Mac. So Apple, as any company from day one, trying to kind of lock their customers in by providing a fantastic experience. But right now, as we all see, every company is trying to do that. Google, Huawei, Samsung, OnePlus, many others. So guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Listen, this video was a lot harder to make because when it comes to features, when it comes to what a phone can do, how the phone can do it, and how much of it the phone can do, Android kind of definitely wins, right? Which is why if you guys saw the first part to this video on why I like Android more than iOS, I spent more of that video actually showing you features. But in this video, as you guys may have noticed, it was a little bit boring, but not my fault, it was boring because the iPhone only has a few things going for it. Just really optimized software with really optimized hardware. And if you're in the US, iMessage. If iPhone didn't have any of those three, we would all be using Androids full time, right? Full time. If I wasn't in America and if all my family had WhatsApp or Telegram, I wouldn't be using an iPhone. That's really the only reason I do use an iPhone is just because I can communicate with my family much easier. There's FaceTime built into the phone. They don't need to download anything. I don't need to call them and be like, go into the Google Play Store, look up Duo, download it. Too much, right? iMessage, iMessage, FaceTime is already built into the phone. That's kind of why I use my iPhone as a daily driver. If it wasn't for that though, Android. So if you guys got this far into the video, again, I don't know how far this is. I'm at 37 minutes right now. I'm probably gonna cut this video down into under 10 minutes. But anyway, if you guys did get this far, I'll leave an emoji of your favorite animal. That's it. That's all I ask. I love you. See ya.